Welcome to our service of Compline this Tuesday, the 12th of November. I'm Reverend Carole with the Kingsbury and Baxterley Group of Churches. This evening, we are going to celebrate Tysilio, who was an abbot in Wales, and also Machar, who was a bishop in Scotland. So, a bit of information. Firstly, about Tysilio. Tysilio was the son of Brochwel Iscithrog, Prince of Powys. Against his father's will, he became a member of a religious community established by Gwythfach at Myford. Tysilio succeeded Gwythfach as Abbot of Myford, and under his leadership, it became the most important religious centre in Powys. St. Bueno spent 40 days there with Tysilio after Berieux was overrun by the Saxons. The cluster of churches dedicated to Tysilio in Montgomeryshire and Denbighshire reflect his influence in the area. Three other dedications in Anglesey, Ceredigion, and on the borders of Carmarthenshire and Pembrokeshire give credence to the tradition that he left Powys for a time in order not to be forced to become its prince. After his death, Tysilio became seen as the saintly protector of Powys. He is depicted as much in a famous poem written in the 12th century by Synthelu Bridith Mala. I apologise for my pronunciations. Welsh names are not my forte. And secondly, Machar. Machar was born in Ireland of princely parentage and was baptised by Colman. He accompanied Columba to Iona, from where he moved to Mull, allegedly because his sanctity aroused the jealousy of some of the other monks. Later, he established a mission in the northeast of Scotland on the site that came to be occupied by the cathedral in Old Aberdeen, which is dedicated to him. St. Machar's well beside it traditionally provided water for local baptisms. So that's information about Tysilio and Machar. So let us take a moment of quiet as I attempt to share my screen in the usual way. Words you see in bold are for you to join in with, should you wish to do so. Otherwise, just listen and enjoy. Top left, the icon at the top on the right is Saint Tysilio and this strange person wearing the green and a very long beard is said to be Gwythfach. And the church here is St. Tysilio's church. And down here on the right, this painting is Machar in his bishop's regalia. And this is the, at the bottom is the cathedral in Aberdeen. So, let us begin. The Lord Almighty grant us a quiet night and a perfect end. Amen. Be sober, be watchful. Your adversary, the devil, prowls around and like a roaring lion seeking someone to devour. Resist him, firm in your faith. We take a moment of quiet as we reflect on the past day, the past week. Bring our thoughts and concerns to God. knowing how much we are in need of his grace and forgiveness. We listen now to Tysilio's Ante Terminum, at least when it loads. My apologies if there are adverts at the beginning. Yes,
Come with us on a journey to a more sustainable future and take pride in offering a quality coffee choice to your employees.
Saving big with Kloner, you're so smart.
There we go. Let us confess our sins to Almighty God. We say together, Most merciful God, we have sinned in thought and word and deed. We are truly sorry and we ask you to forgive. Help us by your Spirit to live the new life in Christ, loving you with all our heart and our neighbours as ourselves. For Jesus Christ's sake. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon us, forgive us our sins, and keep us in life eternal. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Let us worship the Lord. All praise to his name, Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. And our psalm this evening is Psalm 4. Answer me when I call, O God, defender of my cause. You set me free when I am hard pressed. Have mercy on me and hear my prayer. You mortals, how long will you dishonour my glory? How long will you worship dumb idols and run after false gods? Know that the Lord does wonders for the faithful. When I call upon the Lord, he will hear me. Tremble then and do not sin. Speak to your heart in silence upon your bed. Offer the appointed sacrifices and put your trust in the Lord. Many are saying, oh, that we might see better times. Lift up the light of your countenance upon us, O Lord. You have put gladness in my heart, more than when grain and wine and oil increase. I lie down in peace. At once I fall asleep. For only you, Lord, make me dwell in safety. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Our scripture reading this evening comes from the prophet Jeremiah, chapter 14, verse 9. Lord, you are in our midst. We are called by your name. Do not desert us, O Lord our God. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. Thanks be to God. Into your hands, O Lord, I commit my spirit. Into your hands, O Lord, I commit my spirit. You will redeem me, O Lord God of truth. I commit my spirit. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Into your hands, O Lord, I commit my spirit. Save us, Lord, while we are awake. Guard us while we are asleep, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep may rest in peace. And we listen to Voces 8 again, their version of the Nunc Dimittis, hopefully without adverts.
Get ready to crumble!
Let's get ready, ready, let's get ready, ready. Watch us wreck the mic, watch us wreck the mic, watch us wreck the mic. Psych! Let's get ready to crumble! Let's get ready to crumble! Get ready, get ready, get ready!
Save us, Lord, while we are awake. Guard us while we are asleep, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep may rest in his peace. Let us affirm our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Let us pray for the coming of God's kingdom in the church and in the world. Keep the church ever obedient to the call of God, to fulfill the mission entrusted to her. Bless with strength and perseverance those who are called to be ministers of the gospel. Bless those who have gone out into the world, forsaking much for the sake of the gospel. May their message be heard for the peace of the nations and for the peace in human hearts. As we go to our daily work, keep us mindful of the faith to which we have been called. Make us ready to serve others and to tell the good news of the kingdom. Have compassion on those who are lonely when loved ones have gone away to follow new paths of life. Give them assurance of the divine love that is always with them and the human love which endures in absence. We lift to you, Lord, all those who are ill at this time, especially those in our parish who have asked for our prayer. We pray for those who have ended their work in this world and come to the kingdom, including Romeo Davies, Hazel Lunn, Valerie Wiley, Peter Sharrett, Jean Prue, Leslie Clark, Sheila Kirkland, and Yvette Allsop. Let the voice which first called them to faith now call them home to glory. May our prayers be accepted through Christ, who calls us to follow him. Amen. And as our Saviour taught us, so we boldly pray. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Bless the Lord, the God of our fathers. Sing his praise and exalt him forever. Bless the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Sing his praise and exalt him forever. Bless him in the heights of heaven. Sing his praise and exalt him forever. The Almighty and most merciful Lord, guard us and give us his blessing. Amen. Will you not give us life again, O Lord, that your people may rejoice in you? Show us your mercy, O Lord, and grant us your salvation. Keep us tonight, Lord, from all sin. Have mercy on us, Lord, have mercy. Lord, hear our prayer, for we put our trust in you. And the collect for Tysilio. Father of all, who called Tysilio to flee his father's house and to dwell in solitude in the isles of the Western Sea, grant that we, following his example, May be prepared to give up all that would hinder us from following the footsteps of your Son, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be all honour and glory, now and forever. Amen. The Lord is here. His Spirit is with us. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Almighty and merciful Lord, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, bless and preserve us. Amen. Concludes our service of Compline for this Tuesday, the 12th of November. I wish you all a peaceful, quiet, and safe night, and look forward to seeing you again next week. In the meantime, take care. God bless.